In part 4 of our lesson on the trigonometric functions, we're going to learn how to use notational shortcuts and evaluate expressions. So first off, when you see this notation, sine squared theta, that's going to just be shorthand for the quantity of sine of theta squared. So when we look at this first example, and we want to evaluate cosine squared of 90 degrees minus 2 times the sine of 270 degrees. Okay, what that really means is we're going to take the cosine of 90 degrees and square it. Then we're going to subtract 2 times the sine of 270 degrees. Now, if we look at our summary chart for the trig values of the quadrantal angles, we can see that the cosine of 90 degrees is 0, square it, and the sine of 270 degrees is negative 1. So this turns into 0 plus 2, which is equal to 2. It's CYU time, so pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. Okay, let's see how you did. We see we have tangent of 360 degrees minus 3 times the secant of 180 degrees squared minus 6 times the cosecant of 270 degrees cubed. Substituting in the values, we know that the tangent of 360 is 0. We know that the secant of 180 degrees is negative 1, and we're going to have to square that. We know that the cosecant of 270 degrees is negative 1, and we're going to have to cube that. So here, we're going to have negative 3 times, of course, when we take negative 1 and square it, it becomes positive 1, minus 6 times, now the quantity negative 1 to the third power will be negative 1, so this is going to become negative 3 plus 6, which is equal to 3. In this next example, we have to evaluate the cosine of the quantity 2n plus 1 times 180 degrees. Now, remember that n stands for an integer. So let's just take a minute and understand what's happening with 2n plus 1. Integers are negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2. If n is negative 2, then 2n plus 1 would be 2 times negative 2 is negative 4, plus 1 is negative 3. If n is negative 1, 2 times negative 1 is negative 2, plus 1 is negative 1. If we plug in 0, 2 times 0 is 0, plus 1 is 1. If we plug in 1, 2 times 1 is 2, plus 1 is 3. And if we plug in 2, we see we're going to get 2 times 2, which is 4, plus 1, which is 5. So 2n plus 1 yields the odd integers. So when we want to evaluate what's happening in this argument, what that really means we're doing is taking all of these odd integers, right, the 2n plus 1, and multiplying by 180. So we'd be taking the cosine of negative 3 times 180 degrees. We'd be taking the cosine of negative 1 times 180 degrees. The cosine of positive 1 times 180 degrees. The cosine of 3 times 180 degrees. On and on. Okay, so now let's see where those angles live. Well, let's start with the easiest ones. We know 180 degrees lives right here. If we were to do 3 times 180 degrees, you could just calculate that out, and you discover, of course, that that's 540 degrees, which also lives here on the negative x-axis, right? Because all the way around would be 360, add another 90 to get 450, add another 90 to get 540. Another way to think of that 3 times 180 is to do 180 degrees 3 times. So you start here and you go, that's 1 times 180, 2 times 180, 3 times 180, and we land over here again on the negative x-axis. Now, that same is going to be true as we go on and on and on. If the next one would be 5 times 180, so we could go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times 180 also lands here. Now, if we check out going in the negative direction, right, we know negative 1 times 180 would land right here. Negative 3 times 180 would mean to go negative 1, negative 2, negative 3 times 180. And you can see that all of these are also falling on the negative x-axis. So no matter what the multiple is, because it's an odd multiple, it's always landing over here. And we know that the cosine of any angle that's over here on the negative x-axis is going to be negative 1. Now in this next example, we have to find the cotangent of the quantity 2n plus 1 times 90 degrees. It's CYU time, so pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. Okay, let's see how you did. As we just saw in the previous example, we know that 2n plus 1 is going to yield the odd integers. So if we kind of just want to get an idea of what we're talking about here, let's plug in a few odd integers to see what we're going to have to do. The cotangent of negative 3 times 90 degrees, the cotangent of negative 1 times 90 degrees, the cotangent of positive 1 times 90 degrees, the cotangent of 3 times 90 degrees, dot, dot, dot. This should give us some idea. Let's take a look at where these angles live. So let's just start down the list. We know that negative 3 times 90 is negative 270, so negative 270 would be up here on the positive y-axis. Negative 1 times 90 would be down here on the negative y-axis. Positive 1 times 90 would be up here on the positive y-axis. And 3 times 90 is 270, which we know lives here. We can see that all our angles are either falling on the positive y-axis or they're falling on the negative y-axis. Now, let's think about the cotangent in those locations. We know cotangent of theta is equal to x over y. So here on the positive y-axis, we know we can think of this as the point 0, 1. So we would have our x value is 0 and our y value is 1, which equals 0. If we were to evaluate down here, cotangent theta, same thing, x over y. Down here, our point would be 0, negative 1. So we would have x is 0, y is negative 1, which also equals 0. So what we notice is whether we're on the positive y-axis or we're on the negative y-axis, the cotangent of theta always works out to be 0 there. So then the cotangent of 2n plus 1 times 90 degrees is always equal to 0.